How many fish can you fit in a saltwater tank? Definitive answers for 5 different tank sizes, including recommended stockless. Here we go. The old adage that you can put 1 inch of fish per 1 gallon or 5 gallons or 10 gallons of salt water just doesn't make sense anymore. There are 3 things to consider when deciding how many fish you can safely add to an aquarium: the fish itself, the habitat, and the filtration. When thinking about the right fish, we'll need to consider how large they will be when fully grown, what they eat and how often they eat it, how docile or aggressive they are toward other fish, and where in the tank they're gonna live. Next, we'll need to consider the habitat inside the tank itself. Is it a tall tank or a short and long tank? Is there a sand bed, and if so, how deep is it? Are there simple plastic decorations or an elaborate rock structure with caves for hiding? The 3rd key factor to consider when deciding how many fish we can add to our saltwater aquarium is the filtration. How much filtration is there currently on the tank, and how much more are we willing and able to add? Depending on your system, you may be able to go absolutely crazy with filtration and add things like a fleece roller, a protein skimmer, macroalgae refugium, turf algae scrubber, and an automatic water change system. All those filtration options can mean the difference between 5 and 25 fish in a tank. The first tank we're gonna look at today is the 15-gallon HelloReef all-in-one kit. It comes with a rear filtration chamber with filter sock, sponge, and ceramic media. Inside the display portion, the habitat consists of a reef rock structure and a 1.5-inch sand bed. We're assuming a semi-weekly filter sock change and a somewhat large 20 to 30% weekly water change. So how many fish can you fit in this 15-gallon aquarium? 3. 3 fish. I would recommend a small pair of your standard Ocellaris clownfish and some sort of small goby and pistol shrimp combo. A Yasha goby would be absolutely perfect for this tank. Of course, we're just talking about fish here, not other inverts. This 15-gallon habitat can be filled with corals, anemones, sea urchins, snails, and hermit crab to make a very lively habitat indeed. Our second tank is this 25-gallon all-in-one lagoon. It's long and short, meaning significantly more horizontal space compared to the 15-gallon HelloReef cube. Its rear filtration chamber will have a filter sock and fiber filter balls as primary mechanical filtration. And since the rear filtration is large, we're gonna have the ability to add either a protein skimmer or a hang-on-the-back refugium if we need to. The display portion is gonna have a 1-inch deep sand bed and plenty of rock work to provide hiding places for fish. We'll be relying on a weekly 10 to 15% water change schedule, as well as a twice a week filter sock swap as our primary filtration. But if we stock it a little too heavily, we reserve the right to add a protein skimmer and to increase our water change schedule. So inquiring minds want to know, how many fish can you add to this 25-gallon system? 10. 10 fish. As long as you choose the right ones, of course. And here is what I would add to this tank: a pair of Ocellaris clownfish, 5 schooling masked gobies, a Bengai or pajama cardinal fish, a Yasha goby with pistol shrimp, and a 6-line wrasse. This is a pretty good mix of smaller fish that live in different areas of the tank that should ignore each other and live together peacefully. And of course, as with all of the 5 tanks we're talking about today, feel free to fill it with anemones, corals, and a whole bunch of other cool invertebrates. Moving on to tank number 3, this 48-gallon lagoon style from MaxSpec. At 3 feet long and 20 inches wide, the dimensions are similar to a standard 40-gallon breeder setup, but this setup includes a sump and significant filtration power. We'll be filtering our water in the sump with filter socks and a protein skimmer, with plenty of leftover space for something like a turf algae scrubber or a macroalgae refugium. This 48-gallon tank will have a 2-inch deep sand bed, as well as a large rock structure with a whole bunch of nooks and crannies for fish to hide. A weekly 10% water change, a semi-weekly changing out of the filter socks, as well as an occasional dumping out of the protein skimmer collection cup will be our primary filtration for this tank. So how many fish can you put in this 48-gallon tank? 17. 17 fish, as long as you choose the correct mix of size, personality, and habitat. And here's what I would put in this tank: 2 Ocellaris clownfish, 2 pajama cardinal fish, 1 sand sifting goby, 1 firefish, 1 fairy wrasse, 6 masked gobies, 1 sailfin algae-eating blenny, 1 aptasia-eating filefish, and 1 long-nosed hawkfish. This is a heavy-ish stock list, but I'm confident that the sump and all the filtration power inside of it will be able to cope with the heavy bioload. A couple quick notes for you. Hawkfish sometimes will go after your shrimp, and aptasia-eating filefish may nip at your corals, so just keep an eye on them. Our fourth build when answering the question, how many fish can I put in a saltwater aquarium, is this 82-gallon aquarium with sump from Aquaforest. Compared to the previous 48-gallon lagoon-style tank, the footprint is relatively similar even with 34 more gallons in this setup. That's because this 82-gallon aquarium has more typical dimensions, meaning it's just a bit taller. This means that while adding a much larger water volume, it has less than 1 square foot of additional surface area, so we can't add as many fish as we think. Filtration-wise, this one's almost the exact same as the 48-gallon lagoon with filter socks and a protein skimmer and plenty of space to expand. So we still need to answer the question, how many fish can I put in this 82-gallon aquarium? 23. 23 fish. Since the footprint is almost identical to the smaller 48-gallon lagoon tank, we can only add a few more fish, and here's what I would put inside. 2 clownfish, 3 pajama cardinal fish, 1 sand-sifting goby, 1 firefish, 1 fairy wrasse, 10 mass gobies, 1 sailfin algae-eating blenny, 1 aptasia-eating filefish, 1 long-nosed hawkfish, and 2 clown gobies. Lots of small fish here, especially with our 10 mass gobies, and if you choose small, peaceful fish, you can add a lot to this tank. Our fifth build is this 150-gallon peninsula-style tank from Red Sea. With 150 gallons in the display, plus 36 additional gallons in the sump, it's a large system. We are going to assume filtration to the max with fleece roller mat, protein skimmer, and either a macroalgae refugium or turf algae scrubber. At 5 feet long and over 2 feet wide, this tank has a large footprint great for larger fish, such as tangs and angelfish. But to add a lot of fish, we will need to keep the number of larger fish down to a minimum. So how many fish can we put in this 150 gallon tank? 52. 52 fish, and here's my sock list. 3 tangs, 5 antheus, 2 clownfish, 1 rabbitfish, 6 chromis, 1 coral beauty angelfish, 2 sand-sifting gobies, 2 algae-eating blennies, 2 mandarin dragonettes, 1 midas blenny, 15 schooling masked gobies, 1 copperband butterflyfish, 2 firefish, 2 shrimp gobies, 2 hawkfish, and 5 cardinalfish. Click here for another great video from HelloReef, and until next time, be well and happy reefing, everybody.